Hello everyone. First I want to say sorry that the video isn't totally focused. I don't know what happened, but yeah, I still want to show you what I made. So sorry for the first part of the video. At the end of this video you get a close-up and then you can see it all sharp. But I'm using a canvas of 40 by 40 centimeters. I primed it as usual with two layers of gesso and two layers of acrylic paint, and I chosen the deep turquoise. And all the colors I'm using are listed in this video and also in the description box. I already put some clear resin down, and I'm leaving the middle part without the clear resin, because I want the middle part to stay as it is as I pour the colors on it. And I'm using mainly the peacock colors. And I'm hoping that in some places the background color, the color that I have now on the canvas, shines through. So I'm spreading my clear resin on the canvas, and I also taped the back so that the back stays as clean as possible. And I'm pouring a white line over on my canvas. This white of stone coat. And I'm starting with two puddles. This is a very nice blue color, and it's from Artisu. The electric blue, and that's a powder, very sparkly. And the next color is a plum of Color Obsession, also very nice, very deep color. And on top of that is the turquoise blue of Lures, and this is a paste. And that way I'm building those puddles. The very nice bright gold of Artisu. I like that paste a lot. And you can see that it where I didn't put any clear resin, that the puddles don't flow. So I'm pouring a little bit of white around it, not too much, so that it can flow a little bit into the white. And on top of the gold, I'm using the emerald green of Just Resin. Very nice metallic color. Now some heat. And this can flow over the sides. I don't mind. I like that. And you already see that there are forming some cells. This is a ink, an FW ink, the moon violet, very transparent. So I'm hoping that the background color shines through. I like that. Not a lot, just a little bit. And the cells are getting bigger. And on the other side, also with ink, but then a waterfall green, also an FW ink by Dallarani. Again, the plum, very nice color, the plum. Some more gold. And I'm getting some nice effects. I'm liking this. Again, some heat. Little bit of white against the gold. And it already started to flow over the sides. I like that, because then the puddle gets another shape. Now I'm trying to blow the plum and the gold over the white. And now I'm using another attachment on my heat gun. Now you can see I blow it over the white, and then you get cells. So again, the stone coat, this white, is performing very well. You get so much nice effects with it. Again, the paste of Lares, the turquoise blue, very bright turquoise color, making some lines. And in the middle, I want to have a small puddle, and then mainly gold and plum. So I'm starting with a plum. Then the turquoise blue. And on top some gold. But I want to have that part stay as it is if I put heat on it, that it doesn't flow too much to the sides. And that's why I didn't put any clear underneath it. So I'm heating it up. And very carefully I blow on top of the puddle, not onto the sides, but on top. So then it spreads out and it goes back to the inside, and then you get your cells. Also some glitter in this painting. This is also by Recollections, and I'm using the Peacock and Paradise. Two very nice glitters, very fine. And if you don't want your glitter to sink to the bottom, then you need to put a lot of glitter in a little bit of resin. Or you can pour first some clear where you want to have the glitter, and you pour the glitter on top of the clear. I'm using the heat gun for the air bubbles. And I'm liking it that in the corners, the color of the canvas is still intact, that it shows through. Some really nice big cells you see in the middle part, and also in the green. I'm touching up the sides, and I'm not covering the whole side because I like the dripping effect, the organic look of it. So I'm not going to cover it with all resin. So almost done with the sides. Again some glitter. To make the line a little bit wider, that's why I'm pouring another line on top of the glitter I already had. And the painting is almost done. At the end of this video, also a close-up, but what I already mentioned, and that's in focus, so then you can see it a little bit better. So this is how it looks when it's dry. I like it very much. It has some great effects. There you can see it already in the gold. And a very nice emerald green and the middle part with the very large cells. In the plum, it sparkles a lot. Also the glitter, very nice. There you see the canvas color I painted. There are also some very nice effects, multicolored cells, little bit closer to the middle part, also more colors in cells than only one. The nice plum, also some small cells, the glitter, very nice. That's the nice electric blue, very sparkly. Also there are some cells, some very small cells, very nice. Again the middle part where you see some great crazy effects. I'm very pleased with this painting. So if you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel. If you have questions or tips or comments, place them under the video or send me an email, then I can get back to you. You can also find me on Facebook and on Instagram. All the links you need to know are in the description box. Also where I buy my materials. And give me a thumbs up if you like what I'm doing, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye!